Israelites to be above all the people on this planet.
That's upon the face of the earth.
Upon what?
The face of the earth.
So an Arab man is not better than the Israelite man.
Right.
An Edomite or a so-called Caucasian is not better than the Israelite man.
Right.
All right, so sis, you got a question? Go ahead. No, sis. Right here. You can ask.
I just want to know, because everybody keeps saying ain't number one God, but everybody got a different denomination. So what's the difference?
Yeah, that's a good question. Everybody does have different denominations.
Yes, because just like last week, about 2 weeks ago, rather, okay, I was over to my brother-in-law house, and he opened the door for the Seventh-day Adventist, and they was like, they was teaching different from what I know. I'm a Baptist. So they was teaching different, and like I told him, all y'all doing is just rewording. Y'all
hold on, brother. You can't step on the side.
Sister's talking right now.
Y'all rewording it. Y'all wording the way y'all want to word it. But see, I'm just trying to find out what's the difference.
Okay. All right. The different denominations are garbage. All of them stem from this man right here.
Right.
Because if you go back in the history, Islam actually stemmed from a so-called Caucasian.
Right.
It's different from him. Christianity is different from a so-called Caucasian. All the different religions that we practice in this earth stem from so-called Caucasian. So let's get the Bible. What that says.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and verse 17.
Read.
They sacrifice unto devil.
So this is showing you in those different religions how they do. They do everything opposite of what the Bible tells them to do.
Right.
So they sacrifice unto devils. It goes into the action of doing things or going against the laws of the Most High God. Read.
Not to God.
Not to God. Read.
To gods whom they knew not.
For gods that we didn't know not in the past. Read.
To new gods.
To new gods. That's new religions. Read.
That came newly out.
Hello. Newly out. Read.
Whom your fathers feared not.
That our fathers didn't fear their gods because our fathers didn't know about it. Because our fathers are the 12 tribes of Israel. We didn't know about Christianity. We didn't know about Christ being that color. Christ was always a black man according to the Bible.
Right.
Always. We know. Hold
verse
on, brother.
18.
I'm gonna deal with you.
Of the rock they begot thee.
Why are you pushing on me? Don't
thou care. Art unmindful. And thou hast forgotten God that formed thee.
So they forgotten God because in these religions it's false. You know what? Hey, bro, get out of her face.
Brother.
Get out of her face.
Back up. Back up. Back up from her. Back up.
So six.
Back
up.
Okay.
Give me James 1. And 26 is the last verses. Because sis, do you know what religion means? Back up. I'm not answering your question. So sis, you know.
She's with me.
You know what religion
means?
No,
I'm not with you. I don't even know you. Yes, I do. So if you don't mind with your back up, please.
Sis. Don't mind him. This is a devil.
I know.
This is a devil. So do you know what religion means? Anybody? Do you know what it means? You know what it means, sis?
Right here.
Okay, religion, the word religion comes from the word religio, it's Latin. It means to bind down, to hold, and to pass, to hold in captivity up, right? So let's get this. Yeah, go ahead.
The book of St. James, chapter 1, verse 26.
So I'm proving you that God did not never give us religion. Read.
If any man among you seem to be religious.
So if any man among us seem to be religious, read.
And we got...
Right,
but that is not his tongue.
Why do it's not your tongue? You can't control your mouth nor your emotion. Like this brother right here. This would be a religious man in this context. He doesn't know what he's talking about, and then it's foolishness that he's spewing out. Read on, watch.
But deliver his own heart.
And he can't deliver his own heart with the things that he knows. Read.
This man, religion is vain.
This man's religion is vain because it's not coming out of the word of God. Read on.
No, pure religion.
What?
Pure religion.
So, like I said, religion means to bind down and to fasten. Pure religion is something different. Let's get pure. Let's break down pure. Give me Proverbs 30 and 5. Because this is the devil right here.
Hey,
he's drunk.
Back up, brother.
This is the
back
devil.
Up.
He's trying to take you out of the word of the Most High God. He's trying to. But all praise you got patience right now. All right, read on.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 30 and verse 5.
So we're breaking down pure.
At?
Read.
Every word of God is pure.
Every what?
Proverbs. Every word of God is pure.
Oh, the only thing that God spoke was his commandments.
Right,
so every word of God is pure. Read on.
He is a shield unto them that put their trust in him.
So if you do God's commandments, you have nothing to fear. Everything will work out because his commandments are orderly, all of them. Go back to James.
The book of St. James, chapter 1, and verse 27.
Read on.
Pure religion.
So pure religion, this means the words that are coming out of God's mouth or his laws, that's what we are bound by. That is what holds us down. That is what fastens us. Because everybody that's in the world's religion, it holds them down and binds them and fastens them from the truth. The religion that this pure religion that it's talking about is what doing God's commandments, doing his law, statutes, and commandments, loving your brother as yourself. All those, you know.
Pure religion and undefiled before God.
Undefiled meaning you're without sin, meaning that you're doing the commandments. Read.
Undefiled before God and the Father is this. To visit the fatherless and the widow and their affliction.
And that's what we're doing out here. Because we have a lot of fatherless brothers, a lot of fatherless sisters. At the same time, we visiting our brothers and sisters in their affliction when life is hard at this time. That's why we're out here, to get you up out of the affliction. You know?
And to keep himself unspotted from the world.
And this, through our actions, you would tell that we're different because our actions will keep us without sin. So let's define what sin is. Give me that first time.
Bring it out.
Because we have to define these words to see who is the liar and who's telling the truth. Because that's actually what you ask. When you ask about the different denominations. Who is lying, who's telling the truth? We're gonna show you. Read.
The definition of sin, the book of 1 John, chapter 3 and verse 4. Whoso committeth sin transgresseth also the law.
So the Bible said whoever commits sin, you break the law. The transgress means to break or go against. Right. So that also tells you that sin can only happen to the people that was given the law.
Right.
Read on.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
So now it's further defining it. Sin is like unto, it is the transgression of the law. So sin is the breaking of God's law.
Right.
So with us as Israelites, we are commanded to keep God's law.
That's right.
Now let's get another point. Give me 1 John chapter 2. Start at verse 3. Because if they're not following God's commandments, they are liars.
Right.
Point blank and simple. Read on.
The book of 1 John, chapter 2 and verse 3.
Read on.
And hereby we do know that we know him if we keep his commandments.
So we can say that we know the Most High. We can say we know Christ because we keep his commandments. Read on.
Verse 4.
Uh-huh.
He that say, I know him.
So any man that say, oh, I know Christ. I know God. I know about him. I know the name. Read on.
And keep it, not his commandments.
So, if he's not keeping the commandments of the dress code, keeping the commandments of a beard as a man, we have certain dress codes as brothers and sisters. Sisters have a particular dress code they have to wear.
Right.
So, read that again.
Verse 4.
Uh-huh.
He that said, I know him.
Uh-huh.
And keep it not his commandments.
And keep not commandment one. Read.
Is a liar.
Is a what?
Is a liar.
Is a what?
Is a liar.
So now we got to get into the commandments. So because that's all this book is about. First, give me Nehemiah 8 and 8.
Bring it out.
Because the Bible always tells you what type of book it is. It tells you who is it for. It tells you how to perform the steps. And it goes into detail of the steps.
Right.
Meaning the commandments. So let's get Nehemiah 8 and 8 to see what type of book this is. Read.
The book of Nehemiah, chapter 8 and verse 8.
Read on.
So they read in the book in the laws of God.
They read what?
So they read in the book in the law of God.
So this is called the law book. It's called the book of the law. That's what it's called. Read on.
Distinctly and
carefully.
And gave the sense.
And we're supposed to break down every scripture and give the sense to our people so they can perform the commandments. Read.
It caused them to understand the reading.
And we're supposed to cause you to understand the reading upon precept, line upon line. So we're following scriptures as we're giving you the understanding thereof.
Yes.
So, real quick, sis, this is a law. You have to read. Give me Deuteronomy 22 and 5. Because if you can bind yourself on this sign, you are commanded to keep God's laws. It ain't no accident. You gotta put yourself in this. God is the creator of all things. Why in the world he has to ask a human to keep his own commandments? It's a commandment. That means I made you for this purpose, keep it. I made you for this purpose, keep it. Everybody is in their rightful place except Jacob. Right. When I say Jacob, I'm referring to the 12 tribes of Israel, meaning the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The Arabs are in their rightful place, but Jacob. Jacob want to be everybody else but Jacob.
Right.
So we're going to show you how to be Jacob.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 5.
Read.
The woman.
Whoa. So this is declared to the woman. Watch your back, bro.
Brother. The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So this is a dress code that we must follow. So start at the man.
A man shall not put on a woman's garment.
So what is a woman garment that a man should not wear? Explain. What is a woman's garment or woman's article of clothing?
And do their nails and women clothing and women's shoes and stuff like that. That's what you're talking about, baby?
Yes, ma'am. So define, you said dresses, pantyhose, bras, panties. That's, that pertains to a woman. Now, let's read the top of the verse.
First five, the woman shall not.
So this is targeted to the woman. Read.
Where? That which pertaineth unto a man.
So what belongs to a man that a woman wears today?
Pants.
It ain't no such thing as women pants, sis.
Right.
That was crafted counsel to keep our people in sin.
Right.
You gotta think about this. Esau or the so-called Caucasians, they know who we are. The other nations know who we are. So this land was built off our sin. So if we get out of sin, what you think gonna happen to this land? If we start keeping God's laws, what will happen to this land?
It will be great. It'll be better.
It will perish.
That's
it will be destroyed. Because this land was built off our sins. So sis, something as simple as you wearing a dress. You gotta think about this, because this is spiritual. These laws are spiritual. Give me that real quick. Romans 7. Because we have to do the physical aspect as well as break down the spiritual aspect of why we wear what we do. While we do what we do, right? So, with those pants, you put on a very masculine spirit on. You start to carry yourself as a man. You start to buck up on men. That's not your place. Read that.
The book of Romans, chapter 7, and verse 14.
Read.
For we know that the law is spiritual.
Read on.
But I'm carnal, sold under sin.
So the law is spiritual. So everything about the law has a spiritual meaning behind it. So with pants, you put on a masculine spirit. One, the physical aspect. You know that you can contract different UTIs wearing pants because the way your body is made, sis, it's supposed to breathe. That's the point of a dress. The air is supposed to go in, circulate, breathe out, and then your body cleans itself. So you don't have STIs or you don't stink. And that's in the Bible, that our sisters would stink. So, all right, so sis, our job, keep God's commandments. You just found one, wear pants. Another one, wear fringes. Give me that real quick. Real quick.
The book
These
of
are
the
things right here. We're going to explain. Because this is what's going to get us out of this condition.
Right.
Keeping God's law. Right.
The book of Numbers, chapter 15, and verse 38. Speak unto the children of Israel, and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generation.
Meaning it's foreverly going, read.
And that they put upon them a fringe, a border of a ribbon of blue.
See that ribbon of blue? Read.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord.
So it is our job to put these on our vestures, our clothing, so we can remember the laws of God. Read on. You can keep on. We gonna speak loud, sis.
And do them.
And do them. Read.
And that ye seek not after your own heart.
And we seek not after our own heart. The purpose of keeping the law of the fringe is not to go into idolatry.
Right.
That's the idolatry is different. Ideologies, different philosophies that we go into. These fringes are a safeguard to keep you away from that. All right, so bro, you got a question. Because we're out here to get you right. Because the end is coming. I don't know if you see the news. There's a lot of stuff going on with these other nations. They, did you hear about Korea getting weapons? H-bomb, they blew up, they tested an H-bomb. Did you hear that? So, shouldn't you be getting yourself right? Give me, actually, drop that. Give me Isaiah 54, verse 16. Because we gotta explain that this, all this what's going on in the earth is with biblical prophecy. And it's only happening to get us out of this captivity that we're in. That's the purpose of it, man. So, I wanna see you in the kingdom. Keep God's law.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 54, and verse 16. Behold, I've created the smith.
So, a smith creates weapons. That's the purpose of a smith. He's over the fire. He's banging the sword or whatever weapon he's making. Read. So God has created a man to make weapons. Read.
That bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth the instruments of his work.
And he brings forth those weapons, meaning he does diligent labor and searches to get those weapons fine-tuned so it can kill a mass amount of people. Read.
And I have created the waster.
The what?
The waster.
That is the name of the weapon. We know that there's a slang term when you get wasted, it's either one or two things. You're either drunk or you're dead. You gotta get.
I have created the waster.
So this term of the waster is talking about destruction. I have created a weapon for destruction. Read.
To destroy.
To what?
To destroy.
To destroy. Read on.
Verse 17. No weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper.
So no weapon formed against the Israelites shall prosper. Meaning it's not going to work if you're doing God's laws. Read.
And every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn.
So every time somebody rises up against us, it's not going to faze us. Read.
This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord.
This is the what?
The heritage of the servants of the Lord.
So let's get the heritage real quick. Give me Psalms 11, Psalms 119, verse 111. Because the heritage is very important, bro. Because this is what's going to keep us out of sin.
The 111. Thy testimonies have I taken as inheritance forever.
Thy testimonies have we taken for a heritage forever. Read.
For they are the rejoicing of my heart.
Because keeping God's laws are the rejoicing of our heart. It keeps us out of sin. Keeps us out of trouble with our Heavenly Father. So, bruh, do you understand that the Bible says that God created a smith or a person to make weapons for destruction? Do you understand that? Is that going on in current news? So, would you rather believe a pastor or Muhammad or the Bible, God's word? Because it's lining up. You actually see it happening in front of your eyes. You see that? So let's get you right first. Give me the head cover in 1 Corinthians. Because as a man, you're not supposed to cover your head. That's a law. And we're gonna show you how to perform God's laws. You're not supposed to cover your head when the laws, when the words of the Bible are coming out. Read that.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11 and verse 3.
Read.
But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man.
So it's showing you the divine order. Read.
And the head of Christ is God.
So it's God, Christ, man, woman, children. That's the divine order. Read.
Verse 4. Every man praying or prophesying.
So this is a book of prophecy. So every time somebody's coming out of the Bible, you have to follow this law. Read again.
Every man pray or prophesy, having his head covered, dishonored his head.
So, who is your head, according to this scripture? Who is your head? It's God, Christ, man, woman. Let's read the head again, because we want to explain that first.
Verse 3, but I will have you know that the head of every man.
So the head of every Israelite man
is Christ.
Is Christ. Read on.
And the head of the woman.
And the head of every Israelite woman
is the man.
Is the man.
And the head of Christ is God.
And the leader or the commanding chief of Christ is God. So you see the order. It's God, Christ, man, woman, then the children. Verse 4.
Every man pray or prophesy, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head.
So, who is the head of man? Christ. Exactly. You're right, brother. It's Christ.
But every woman that pray nor prophesy with her head uncovered, dishonoreth her head.
So, it said the man, when you have your head covered while the scriptures are coming out, you dishonor Christ, which is your leader, your head. So, the Bible's coming out. What are you going to do? I don't have no excuse. I know it's cold. Hey, see this? It ain't no excuse, bro.
I know, I got a short haircut.
Yeah, so are you saying you bald?
No, I'm not bald.
So what do you mean by short haircut, bro? You got a cut low? So what? It's either you follow God's laws or you die. It's that simple. That's a simple law, bro. Just take off your hat. Just take off your hat. Just take it off right now. Just right now. All right, bro. Here's your kid.
Verse 5. But everyone.
Hey,
verse 4.
All praises, bro. All praises.
All praises.
Yo.
Every man pray or prophesy, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head.
You dishonor your head, but now you're not dishonoring your head. Meaning you making Christ pleased at looking at you right now. Because you're at least keeping that law. Watch. Don't be ashamed of your hair as well. Because I was about to say, you have Christ, you have God-like hair. Let that thing show. Let's prove that. Give me Revelation 1:14. Because our people are in a decayed state. Our sisters don't know who they are. They are ashamed of who they are. And our brothers are effeminate and don't know who they are. They're ashamed of who they are. They're not ready to stand up to be men. They'd rather be out here walking to and fro doing foolishness. Read on.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 14.
Read.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So his head and his hairs were white like wool, just like your hair, bro. Read.
As white as snow.
As white as snow. Hey, I don't know about you, but I want to get to that age where my hair start turning white where it looks silky, bro. Right. I want that. Read.
The flame of fire.
So his eyes, this is talking about Christ, his eyes were a flame of fire because Christ drunk wine. He didn't drink in moderation. Because when any Negro, when we drink wine, the whites of our eyes turn red. It's just natural. Read.
And his feet, like unto fine brass.
So what is the color of brass, bro? A brown color, right? Now, the Bible's going to tell you the derivative of brown that it is.
As if they burn in a furnace.
So, if that brass object was burnt in a furnace, what color is it going to turn? If it's burnt, that's the hint. Read again. Watch.
And his feet, like unto fine brass, as if they burned.
Like unto, as if they
burned in a furnace.
Burned in a furnace. So anything that burns, what color does it turn? Anything that burns, anything. Black. There you go. So it's showing you there is a color called burnished brass. It's so brown, it looks black. That's the real color. That's the color of Christ in the Bible. So it's showing you he was actually darker than this brother here. He was a lot darker. So read that. Finish it out.
And his voice as the sound of many waters.
And Christ was loud when he spoke to people because he had to teach a multitude of people. That's why he was loud. All right, so, bro, do you understand that? All right, so let's get the law of the fringe again for you. Read that again. Numbers 15. Because we don't wear this for show. I wear this every day.
Right.
Even on my house wear, I have fringes on. This ain't no show that we come out here only on the Sabbath just to wear fringes and talk to our people in any type of way. You know.
The book of Numbers, chapter 15, and verse 38.
Read.
Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them fringes and the borders of their garments throughout their generation.
Throughout our generation.
Read.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue, and it shall be unto you for a fringe.
So, bruh, right here, It says a ribbon of blue, for it be unto us as a fringe. Now it's going to tell you the purpose of why we wear a wreath.
That ye may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord.
So the purpose is to remember all the commandments of the Lord. Meaning, you need to be, you know it's a commandment to study? Did you know that? All right, let's finish this out and we're going to get that.
And do them.
And do all God's commandments, read.
And that ye speak not after your own heart.
And that we speak not after our own heart, read.
And that you speak not after your own heart.
Uh-huh.
And your own eyes, after which you used to go hard.
So that's an example, that's my opinion, what I feel. That's what that's going into. It's speaking everything against the Most High. So, let's get the beer after this.
That ye may remember and do all my commandments and be holy unto your God.
So, these garments set us apart from everybody else. Who else in the earth is rocking fringes and a border of blue on all their garments? These are holy garments because it sets us apart.
Right.
So, when we in these holy garments, we got to act accordingly. So, as a man, brother, if you can grow some hair, grow it. Do not shave. Grow. You're going to get the law. Leviticus 19.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, and verse 27.
Read.
Ye shall not round the corners of your head.
So this is addressed to our men. We as men are not supposed to round the corners of our head, meaning cut off all this. We're not supposed to round. That's balding yourself like Jordan or Tyrese. Read.
Neither shall thou mar the corners of thy beard.
To mar something means to destroy. So we're not supposed to destroy the corners of our beard. Can you accent your line? Yes. But can you go into your natural line? No. That's what destroying the beard is. Finish that out.
Verse 28. Ye shall not make any cuttings in your flesh but the dead.
So, bro, did you know about tattoos?
Hey.
Why? It's what? It's pagan. You can say that. It is. Other nations did that, not us. Read that. Finish it out.
Ye shall not make any cuttings in your flesh for the dead, nor print any marks upon you. I am the Lord.
All right. So let's show, like, you know what today is. Yes. No, today. What is special about today? So what's special about Saturday? So you know about it. All right. So what are we? Do you know what we're not supposed to do and what we are supposed to do on the Sabbath? Yeah. Hey, share. Let's go. What you read? You can just name it. All right, let's get it for you.
Keep it holy.
To keep it holy, so it's separate from all the other days. Read.
6 days shall thy labor and do all thy work.
So 6 days out of the week, you're supposed to labor and do your work. Make your money. Read.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath unto the Lord thy God.
So the Sabbath day is the read that again.
But the seventh day, the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
So the seventh day is the Sabbath day of the Lord our God. Read on.
In it thou shalt not do any work.
So this is one commandment. In the Sabbath day, you're not supposed to be working. There's no work, no work at all that's supposed to be going down. Read on.
Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter.
So this goes into if you had your own business, you're supposed to shut everything down on the Sabbath. Read.
Thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gate.
So this is still going into if you had a business. You're not supposed to be working on the Sabbath day. Read.
Verse 11. For in 6 days hath the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them.
So God worked 6 days, so we're following our Heavenly Father. We got to do the same thing. He worked 6 days, so he created us to do the same thing. We're supposed to work 6 days. And then what happened on the Sabbath?
And rested the seventh day.
And we're supposed to rest on the Sabbath day.
Wherefore, the Lord blessed the seventh day and hallowed it.
And he made it holy because of certain laws that we got to keep. So, you got one law. We're not supposed to be working on the Sabbath day. Give me Exodus 16.
You know.
Because it's more laws that we got to keep it holy. It has to be separated or set apart from all the other days of the week. You know,
the book of Exodus, chapter 15, 16, and verse 23.
Read.
And he said unto them,
uh-huh.
This is that which the Lord hath said. Tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath unto the Lord.
So the day starts at night. Now that's 12:01. We're going to get that too. Actually, get that real quick. Hold that. Because Esau messed us up. He jacked us up with time and all that stuff. So we're going to explain through the Bible how we count our days. Give me Genesis 1.
The book of Genesis, chapter 1, and verse...
Sorry, verse
4. Verse 4. And God saw the light, and it was good.
Uh-huh.
And God divided the light from the darkness.
Read on.
And God called the light day.
He called the light day. Read.
And the darkness he called night.
He called the darkness night. Read.
And the evening.
And the evening. Read.
And the morning.
And the morning. So the night and then the day. Read.
Were the first day.
So you start counting your days at night. So at Friday night, that's the Sabbath. Because it's Saturday. It's the Sabbath. When that sun goes down, it's completely dark outside. That is the next day. So Friday night is the Sabbath. Read. Go back to Exodus.
The book of Exodus, chapter 16, and verse 23.
So you can get a parallel on the time period what it's talking about. Read.
And he said unto them,
uh-huh.
This is that which the Lord hath said.
Uh-huh.
Tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath.
So
unto the Lord.
If tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath, what day are they in? We just said the day starts at night, right? So it's night, then it's day. That's one complete day. So if it says, read that again.
Verse 23, and he said unto them, this is that which the Lord hath said. Tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath unto the Lord.
So tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath. So what is that day?
Sunday?
No, it's Friday. That's before the Sabbath. That's the day before the Sabbath. So Thursday night to Friday night is Friday. Friday night to Saturday night, the Sabbath, that's the Sabbath, that full day. You know.
Bake that which ye will bake today, and sieve that ye will sieve, and that which remaineth over.
So to bake means to cook. To sieve is to steam stuff or boil. To sieve is to get something to a boil. So read.
And that which remaineth over, lay up for you to be kept until the morning.
So you're not supposed to cook on the Sabbath, and you're not supposed to work on the Sabbath. So remember that, bro. You're not supposed to work and cook.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.